Make sure we have gone from a 13.5% uninsured all the way down to the 6.2% uninsured. A dramatic shift, a dramatic turnaround is the chair of the council's committee on health, David Catania. We couldn't be more excited to have him here and to make some remarks about all the great work he's done for the people of the District of Columbia. Council member.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you.
Mr. Mayor, I want to thank you and your administration for having us here today and for the work that our Director of Healthcare Finance, Julie Hudman, has done to pull this report together, because it has finally provided evidence of what we've long believed, which is we're making enormous progress with respect to the rate of uninsured. You know, Mr. Mayor, I've got to take this moment to say that, you know, for years and years and years, this city has had political leadership that has celebrated misery. We have had, how many times have we heard the lost, the last, and the least? You know, people who have used divisiveness to assert a potential political agenda. And what we need are individuals who will sit down and construct solutions. So 5 years ago, when I started chairing the Committee on Health, we had a rate of uninsured that was higher than Maryland and higher in Virginia. And in 5 years, they've stayed the same, and we've cut our rate in half. And so we finally see a government that is delivering for our citizens, consistent with our values. I mean, I feel very fortunate to be able to chair a committee where the residents of our city want to see children covered.
Yeah.
And to have a 3.2% rate of uninsured among children, which ties Massachusetts as the lowest in the nation, that is one-third, frankly, of the national average. It says how generous we are as a city and where our values are. But frankly, 3.2% is too high. And that's why we're here today to talk about Healthy DC and how we're going to continue to expand the options of uninsured for our children and for our adults. Mr. Mayor, while we have representatives from Children's here, I want to thank them for their partnership here. 5 years ago, we started a very exciting partnership with Children. When we had 44% of our schools with full-time nurses, we doubled down with our contract with Children's, and now 99% of our schools have full-time nurses.
All right.
The fourth highest rate in the country, which is extraordinary. We've had increases in preschool immunization, thanks to Children's, from around the high 60s to low 70 with Head Start and preschool to now well over 90%, winning a gold standard from CDC, the only urban jurisdiction in the country. We thank Children's for that. That's exciting news, right?
Fantastic.
And next month, we will see the conclusion of at least the Capitol building of our new Children's National Medical Center run emergency pediatric services at the campus of United Medical Center, just blocks from here, that will bring to the children of communities 7 and 8 the kind of world-class pediatric emergency services that they are entitled to and deserve. And we want to thank Children's for that as well. So, Mr. Mayor, I want to thank you and your administration and Dr. Hudman. I also want to thank my staff. We've been joined by Ben Young and Jordan Hutchinson. I don't think you're going to find a better committee staff in this city or in the country than we have on the Committee on Health. And these changes didn't happen by accident. It happened through hard work and coordination between the council and the executive. And Mr. Mayor, I want to say one last thing. You know, we've had Sharon Baskerville, who's been here, and Bob Mousen, representing our hospitals and our clinics for years, who've been toiling in the vineyard. And they and their members deserve a lot of credit for help pushing us to where we are here as well. I want to end by saying a special thanks to our president. We in the district received an enormous gift 3 weeks ago when the Congress passed the president's health care plan, which is, as the mayor mentioned, is going to permit us to take thousands of residents off completely locally funded insurance programs and put them on a federal Medicaid program where the federal government pays 70% of what we have been paying 100% of. And so that gift came right on time in this difficult budget. And we certainly have difficult days ahead, but one thing I want to commit to, the 200,000 residents of this city who depend on us to provide them health insurance, that commitment is not diminished in these economic downturn. We are not going to backtrack on our advances. We are going to double down and work hard to sustain these advances. And Mr. Mayor, I look forward to working with you in the future to get us to 0% uninsured. That is what I promised the voters when I ran initially, and that's where we are going. And I want to thank you for letting me say a few words, Mr. Mayor.
Great remarks.